Hey guys, welcome to today's video where I want to show something really, really cool. And that is that you can integrate your chatbot with OpenAI and use different kinds of AI models to basically get the best kind of result for your use case. The first thing that you will need to do is to basically connect OpenAI with your UChat workspace. And the way to do that is by going towards the mini app section on the left hand side, nearly down the bottom. And from here, you can say install mini app or install app. I already have it. But if we press the button, you will see it most likely at the time of the recording, at least on the top left corner. If not, you can also just search for it and it will pop up as it should pop up as well. There we go. Right, so you can just install it. Now, upon installation, it will also ask you for an API key. And that API key you can find by going towards the OpenAI URL, and that is beta.openai.com. Also show it popping up in on the screen right now. And I will also leave a link down in the video description. Once here, you can go towards your account icon, personal, on the top right corner, and go with few API keys. Once created, you will get an API key, which you will be able to insert inside the mini app, and then press install, and then it will show up inside of your mini app overview. Now, once this is done, you can basically go and have some fun with OpenAI inside the chatbot, inside of any flow that you set up, right? So the way to do that is as following. I already have a flow set up here, as you can see, and I am just going with a really simple setup. So I have a question that I will save to a custom field called question, as you can see here. Then I will just send a confirmation. Okay, got it, just a second. And then we can go inside of OpenAI. But to make sure that you know how to use this, let's delete this and let's go with add an item. So first add an action block, right? Then add an item, integrations, and if we scroll down to OpenAI, we can now edit the action. There's only one action available for this free mini app for now, but if we take a look inside, you will be able to input the required text, right? And we just ask that and save that inside of a custom field called question. So let's pull that up. There we go. And then we can select our model. Some choices, as you can see here, are Text DaVinci 003, Text Query, Text Babbage, and so on, Text Ada as well. If you want to learn more about which model fits your needs best, you can go back towards OpenAI, go towards the playground on the top menu corner. And from here, you will see at the right-hand side, different kinds of models. As you can see here, Text DaVinci is the latest model and is the most comprehensive, detailed, and precise. But you can also go with Text Query, Text Babbage, and Text Ada, as you can see here. You can also say show more models. You can go with either model, but in on average, Text DaVinci is the proper one to use. So if we go back inside the chatbot, we can basically just copy this. And let's go and make sure we copy this correctly. There we go. And then the next step is to determine the max amount of tokens, basically the max amount of characters. If we go inside the playground again and go towards the description, you will see that Text DaVinci 003 can process up to 4,000 tokens per request. So that means that you can increase this default setting, keep going towards the wrong tab, but you can increase the default setting of 200 by up to 4,000 for this model. If we go towards Text Query, you will see not a specific amount of tokens, but I'm assuming those are all pretty much similar. DaVinci 2 is also 4,000 tokens. DaVinci 1 does not seem to have any tokens displayed. But just assume that 4,000 tokens is the most, and you can adjust that inside this max token. Let's go with 300 for now. Let's go with 300. And then when we get the response back from OpenAI, we need to save that inside of a custom field. We can just go with, let's go with OpenAI response. There we go. Use that as a text. And there we have it. Then the next step is to basically reply with that text. So let's go and find OpenAI. There we go. And then we will wait for 6 seconds and then have a message, want to try again. So really, really simple setup, but let's have some fun with this and see what is possible and what kind of quality output that we get from OpenAI directly. So let's preview this inside of a web overview. And let's enlarge this a little bit. And let's go and have some fun. Let's say, really simple, really generic. Let's see what OpenAI comes up with. So now OpenAI will start generating that and we already get a response back. And as you can see, you don't have to be a marketing guru to master the basics of effective marketing. Here are 3 simple tips to help you get started. So pretty cool that you get this kind of response, right? So 1, leverage digital channels, develop an engaging content strategy, and analyze data. And then we also have some hashtags to help with the reach of the post as well. So let's say we want to try again, and let's say something totally different. And let's see if OpenAI can help us get a starting code together. So we're already getting a response back. And here we go. For GMT, new date, console log, and we can console log this. Inside of UChat, you need to make a few adjustments because console.log is not a valid JS command inside of UChat. Instead, you will need to have some return values here. But in general, this works pretty well. So let's do it one more time. And let's give it something completely different. There we go. So let's see if OpenAI can get us some business advice. So it will take a few seconds and about now around this time it should type. There we go. And let's see. So that is a pretty big response. 1, do your research. 2, have a plan, get the necessary licenses and permits. Establish pricing, manage your finances, network with other businesses, promote your business, find ways to stand out, monitor your progress, and put customer service first. So this is a pretty comprehensive and detailed answer, right? So again, do not ever copy and paste AI just like that. Always give your own personal touch with it. If you are asking for some validation code like this one to convert time into another time zone, right? Always make sure that you test the stuff and do not assume that this is going to be the right code, for example, right? Same with the content. Do be sure that you adjust it and customize it towards your own liking. So always make sure that AI is there to help you speed up your processes like content creation, or help you with coding, figure out what kind of code that you need to use, use it as a baseline, customize it towards your own branding, your own speech, your own tone, right? And just make sure that the content that you produce is unique. So I hope this video helps you out into understanding how to connect OpenAI with your chatbot inside of UChat. And if you have any questions, do let me know. Have some fun playing around with this. And if you want me to record any kind of video as a follow-up to this one, do let me know and I will try to do so for the next one. For now, have a great day, take care, and talk soon.